I've been to many places on the oldest Anarchy server in Minecraft over the years, but there are still plenty of areas that are unknown to me. Whenever players send me coordinates, I'll often travel there to investigate. Sometimes it's a base, sometimes it's a random wheat farm in the middle of nowhere. It's usually a toss-up. Well, recently, I was contacted by a player named Jeffrey214, claiming he had found the ruins of a town from 2012. But not just any town. There were supposedly multiple bedrock structures there, as well as something else. Needless to say, I was highly interested. He didn't know much about the place and figured I might be able to find out more. I had never heard of this town before, and structures made with illegal bedrock are incredibly rare on the server, so documenting them is very important. I had to travel out there and see this place for myself, but a few days after I was given the coordinates, they ended up being posted publicly. I knew I had to make it out there before anyone else, so I could properly document the place and uncover its true history. So today, we are traveling out almost a million blocks to uncover the mystery of this town from 2012, see these illegal structures for ourselves, and find out what this something else could be. I'm both skeptical and intrigued. Before we get started today, since I've been growing a beard recently, it's appropriate that our sponsor this week is Manscaped. They sent me their new and improved Lawnmower 3.0, which has a cutting-edge ceramic blade, battery life up to 90 minutes, waterproof technology so I can use it in the shower, and an LED light which makes it easier to see where you're shaving. It's great for any place on your body that has hair. The USB charging stand is portable, sleek, and will fit in any bathroom easily. I have to say, I was quite impressed with it and never once felt irritation using it. If you want to experience it firsthand and try it for yourself, get 20% off and free shipping at manscaped.com/fitmc. That's 20% off with free shipping at manscaped.com/fitmc. Now then, let's get started. I'm in the Nether right now on an alt account getting ready to head out for our journey today. I have an exploit that will speed up our trip considerably, but I need some wooden planks first, so we need to find a portal. Now for the rest of the video, you're going to notice a sensor bar in the bottom left corner of the screen. This is to conceal my coordinates so that way I know where I'm going, but you don't. No offense. Here we go, this ought to do the trick. I think this is far out enough in the Nether where we should be able to find some trees pretty easily, but I guess we'll see. Alright, looks like we're in a cave. Let's look topside real quick. Alright, perfect, I see trees. Excellent, so we should be able to get some wooden planks. Oh, hold on! Okay, there's something else here. I was not expecting anyone to be building here, and even the owner's horses are still here. That's crazy, because we're still really close to spawn. I'm legitimately surprised. Let's take a look around. There's a little bit of damage here and there, it seems, but it's mostly intact. I would consider this an active spawn base. Look at that. Maybe if we look around, there should be signs of people that were here before us. Wait, what's this? Oh, look at this! All right, a lot of building has been happening here. Wow. This is not something you just build fresh out of spawn. What was supposed to be just a stop for wooden planks ended up being a mini base tour, and I'm not complaining, and I'm sure you're not either. Man, this is crazy. It's in really good... Wait, hold on. Oh, here we go. Welcome to Diamond Town 2020, originally built in 2011 by the Fellowship of the Diamond. It had about 8 players living there at the time. Oh my god, so this is a lot older than I thought it was. At least, according to these signs anyway. Whether it's legitimate or not, I guess we don't know. All the signs at this base are really recent, all 2020, which tells me that this spawn base is probably newer than they were originally claiming. But like I said, I'm gonna look more into it, but they even have farms here and everything. Man, if you were a new player escaping spawn, this would be an oasis. Now that gives a whole new meaning to the term creeper farm. Alright, time to get down to business. I need to craft a boat for this exploit so we can get out there as fast as possible. Like I said, the cords went public, so we do need to make haste. All things considered, it was really cool to find this place. I was not expecting to find anything on the other side of this portal other than trees. So I guess it just goes to show you, curiosity doesn't always kill the cat. But anyway, enough sights and sounds. We need to get out of here and get on with our journey. I last tried this a few days ago, so hopefully it hasn't been patched by the server's admin, Housemaster, yet. Let's give it a shot. Would you look at that? It still works. Fantastic. Not everyone has access to the Boatfly exploit, so we should be able to beat everyone out there to the millions to get to this base. All right, I'm just glad it works. Now, we're going to go into the Nether, find a highway, and use the Boatfly exploit to go as fast as possible, even faster than Elytra's in some cases. There's a portal, so let's get down and get on our way. Oh, hold on. Alright, getting out of the boat is a little glitchy sometimes, but we're good. We're good. Now that we have Boatfly in the Nether, we're turning a trip that would normally take a few days on foot into just a few hours by boat flying. You'll love to see it. The pioneers used to ride these babies for miles. Yeah, oh, hold on. Dead body, our first dead body of the video. You'll love to see it. They got diamond gear and everything. Alright, I'll pick up a couple of those items. As we're traveling down this highway, just for fun, if we see anyone walking, we should try and pick them up. We're going to be the 2B2T Uber today. There's our first customer of the day. Hold on. Elite Peter. Hey, Peter. Hey, Peter. Get in. Get in. That's right. Does he even see us yet? Okay, yeah, now he sees us. Yeah, come on. Get in. Get in. I'm not going to hurt you. Get in. All right, this taxi's about to get crazy. Oh my god, he's probably freaking out right now. Oh my, can you imagine? Oh, no, we dropped him. Get in. I'm sorry. Yeah, he must have glitched out or something. All right, come on, get in. We got places to be, let's go. VTech just kicked in, yo. We're cruise. Oh, hold on, we dropped him again. Come on, you gotta stop getting out, Peter. Oh, he does not want to get back in, understandable. Have a nice day, sir. Alright, anyway, let's continue on here. That was pretty funny. The server's been lagging quite a bit, the TPS is dropping, and we're rubber banding, so we're just kind of taking it easy. Sir, you just hit my vehicle! Well, he didn't have insurance! You really gotta give it to the Nether highway groups. I mean, all these obsidian roads, the infrastructure of the Nether has greatly improved over the past year. Wait, hold on. It looks like we're having some trouble boat flying on this diagonal road here. We might have to get out on foot to continue the journey. But I mean, you know, we got pretty far already, so I'm not complaining too much. And our second dead body of the journey. And it's unenchanted gear, so likely an execution. We're in another tunnel right now, and I'm guessing because there are items still on the ground, this must be the tunnel that Jeffrey made. So if we follow this, we should get to the coordinates of where this base is on the overworld. I also want to use this time to say, if you've been enjoying the video so far, make sure to leave a like and consider hitting that subscribe button. A lot of you are still not actually subbed to the channel, and I would greatly appreciate it. I mean, I'm doing Uber on 2B2T to make ends meet. Come on, throw me a bone here. We're approaching the Nether coordinates of the base, and Yep, sure enough, there's player activity. There's a portal right behind that column over there. Actually, there's several portals. Wow. So this must be the place. Would you look at that? It's a glitched Nether portal. When the portal frames are sideways like that, it means it was generated in a very old version of Minecraft. This portal is 8 years old. So it looks like Jeffrey was telling the truth about this place. Well, it's time for us to head in here and see what we find. The moment of truth. And would you look at that? It's real. The illegal town with bedrock is real. There's been a lot of visitors here already. I'm surprised these ruins have held up as well as they have. I mean, there are actual bedrock houses here. I mean, I'd always heard rumors that there were other bedrock bunkers across the server after we found the first one at Ziggy Town, but this officially confirms it. To have this much illegal bedrock at one base, there has got to be more of it here, so let's look around. And once I have a complete view of the base, we can ask around in the old community to find out what actually happened here. How did this place get destroyed in the first place? Who could have placed this bedrock? Oh, there's another one right over there. Man, this is nuts. Let's take a look inside. Alright, it's just lava. Alright. But man, that's... It still blows my mind that this base has flown under the radar for over 8 years. All of these illegal structures were here. I'm just glad that bedrock deletion has been patched, because if it wasn't, there's no way I would be able to show these on film. Looks like part of the base goes underground here into this tunnel, so let's take a look. A lot of sandstone. Yeah, these are all 2012 blocks using jack-o'-lanterns as light sources. Wow, these must have been stables or something down here with like the grass and stuff. I bet they were feeding livestock. Wow, and it looks like it wasn't even fully completed. You know, because all this was dug out, but part of the wall is missing. So whatever they were trying to build down here, they didn't finish. So we've seen the main part of the base now, but remember, there was supposed to be something else out here. So we need to look around the surrounding terrain and see what we can find. This is another way Boatfly is going to help us today. We can scout the surrounding terrain very quickly and find if there's anything unusual. Lots of old ocean here, and it looks, yep, here's the chunk border. So they generated a lot of ocean, but I'm not seeing anything illegal or unusual out here. So we have to keep looking around. Hold on, there's just one random piece of bedrock down here. That's really weird. Look at this, it's just floating here. I'm not gonna ask any questions, but maybe there's something off in that direction, you know? So let's take a look. All right, here we go, we got something. Oh my God. Are you kidding me? This is the first time I have seen an illegal end portal in over 5 years. The last time I saw one was at the ruins of Camtown in 2015. This is unreal. I remember when I was making the History of the Dragon Egg video, XCC2 told me that the only person that had access to illegals but would always mess up the end portals was Pop Bob. And judging by the signs here, he appears to be the culprit. Alright, it's time for me to take all this info and ask around the community to see if we can uncover the true history of this base. After asking around several of my contacts, I was able to uncover the true story of what went down here and why the base was griefed. The base was founded in 2012 by two players, Stealth Nacho and Zarkrin. Originally, the bunkers were covered in sandstone as part of the build, but eventually, Pop Bob caught wind of the base and traveled on the nether roof to grief it. After blowing the base to smithereens and leaving a bedrock cross, Pop Bob left. Many years later, Courier 6 was able to find the base and take this footage, where he discovered that there were actually two portals, a working one and a broken one. Pop Bob had used the portal to get back to his base. After this location was discovered, at some point, Housemaster removed the working portal, but left the broken one in place, which is what we came across today. It's pretty wild to think just how powerful players were back in the day. Coming all the way out here was definitely worth it, and makes me wonder what other undiscovered bases could be out there. Well, if you enjoyed the video today, leave a like and hit that subscribe button. Also follow me on my socials, but that's it for today, everyone. Take it easy and stay alive out there.